The main profile parameters are defined in the ISO 4287 standard that was published in 1996. This presentation will introduce the amplitude parameters defined in this standard. A measured profile is a series of height values in function of the lateral position. Heights are referenced, by convention, from the mean line, which is calculated as the mean value of all heights. This mean value is set as zero. Heights are positive above the mean line and negative below. A portion of the profile above the mean line, between two zero crossings, is called a profile peak. A portion below the mean line, between two zero crossings, is called a profile valley. They can be combined in a profile element, as a peak followed by a valley, or a valley followed by a peak. One can measure the highest extension of the profile above the mean line. This height defines the parameter PP, called the maximum profile height deviation. The parameter name starts with a capital letter P, as we are on a primary profile. Its suffix is a small p to designate peaks. Similarly, the deepest extension below the mean line defines parameter PV, called maximum profile valley depth. The value of PV is positive because it is counted as a depth, downward from the mean line. The suffix V in PV stands for valleys. Then, the vertical distance between the highest peak and the deepest valley defines parameter PZ and is called maximum height of the profile. This parameter is a first evaluation of the amplitude of texture. However, it is very sensitive to outliers, extreme peaks or valleys that are not significant in terms of function of the surface. The PZ parameter makes it possible to discriminate two surfaces by comparing their maximum heights. Here, we can say that the above profile is rougher than the profile below, by just comparing their respective PZ values. But these values do not tell anything about the texture morphology of the surface. How heights are spread between the min and max values? That we don't know. Here, the two profiles have the exact same roughness amplitude. But if you had to walk, barefoot, on one of these surfaces, I bet you would prefer the surface above. Roughness amplitude alone is not enough to qualify the functional characteristics of the surface. In practice, parameters are usually calculated on a filtered profile. The filtration operation consists of calculating a profile that contains the longest wavelengths, longer than a defined cutoff value. Such a profile is called the waviness. It loosely follows the main long-term variations of the profile, without going into each irregularity. The Gaussian filter, here with a cutoff of 2.5 mm, being subject to end effects, the filtered profile is cut on each edge by a length equal to half a cutoff, or sometimes one cutoff. The resulting length is called the evaluation length. The roughness profile is calculated by subtracting the waviness profile from the primary profile. It is therefore also shorter by half a cutoff at each end. ISO 4288 specifies that the roughness profile is decomposed into small portions, called sampling lengths, that have a length equal to the cutoff value. Parameters are calculated on each sampling length and are combined in an average value, which is normally less sensitive to noise and outliers. The average helped originally to stabilize profilometer results when used in a noisy environment, such as a production line in a factory. By default, 5 sampling lengths are used, but this number can be adapted in the specification, depending on the application. Each parameter is calculated on 5 sampling lengths, which leads to 5 estimator values. The final parameter value is calculated as the average of the estimator values. Some standards do not use sampling lengths, such as the American standard, ASME B46.1, and calculate the parameter directly on the evaluation length. In the forthcoming new ISO 21920 standard, most profile parameters are also defined in the evaluation length, except for maximum parameters, RP, RV, and RZ. Another parameter, RT, or the total height of the profile, can be defined. It is calculated as the sum of the highest RP estimator and the highest RV estimator. RZ is therefore smaller than or equal to RT. On the primary profile, PT equals PZ as there is no sampling length and only one value of each parameter is calculated. So, we have 4 parameters that are applied on 3 profiles: primary, roughness, and waviness. Which makes 12 parameters in total. We can add 4 more parameters. RA, RQ, RSK, and RKU, also considered as amplitude parameters. PA and PQ are both calculated from a mean of all point heights, on the primary profile. In case of a roughness profile, RA and RQ are calculated on each sampling length, then averaged. They are averages of averages. PA uses an arithmetic mean of the absolute values of heights. PQ is the root mean square of all heights. It is therefore the standard deviation of the height distribution. These two parameters are an evaluation of the mean roughness height that is not affected by extreme points. RA is probably the most well-known parameter and the most used in specifications. It does not mean that it is the most useful or meaningful, far from that. But it is usually the only one known by designers. And often the only parameter taught to students. Using RQ instead of RA would provide similar results but with a physical meaning. RQ, as the standard deviation, or in the variance form, is found in several tribology equations. PSK, and also RSK and WSK, is a parameter that qualifies the symmetry or asymmetry of the height distribution. It provides useful and important information on the texture morphology. If its value is significantly negative, it means that the surface has a top plateau with deep grooves or pores. On the contrary, if its value is significantly positive, the surface has a flat bulk with high peaks as if particles are deposited on a plane. This parameter would help differentiate the two profiles we've seen previously with the same PZ value. PKU qualifies the dispersion of the height distribution, also called kurtosis, between the min and max values. If its value is significantly larger than 3, then the distribution is narrow with a few extreme points above and below. Most points are concentrated around the mean value. A small value of PKU means that heights are spread more or less regularly between the min and max values. It is another way to describe the texture morphology. However, skewness and kurtosis are pretty sensitive to the presence of extreme points such as outliers, so they should be used carefully. To finish this presentation, let's examine some practical examples. Here, a profile measured in a cylinder bore of a car engine. The fine mean roughness RA equals 0.5 micrometers is to be compared with the large amplitude RT equals 11 micrometers, due to deep grooves that are produced by honing on the surface to ensure lubrication. The skewness parameter, RSK, is negative and it confirms the presence of scratches below the main surface. The high value of kurtosis, RKU, indicates that most of the texture is concentrated around the mean height, which is high and close to the top of the surface. Another example, measured on a steel sheet. The texture is well centered around the mean height, without extreme points. It is verified with a small value of RSK and a value of RKU smaller than 3. Last example, measured on a ground surface. The distribution shows a nice Gaussian shape, slightly shifted towards the top because of a few deep grooves. Thus, the value of RSK, which is slightly negative, and a large value for RKU. The mean value, RA, is very small compared to the peak to valley RT. All these parameters can be used in specification. Discover more videos and resources on our Surface Metrology Guide. Or visit www.digitalsurf.com.